Hello everyone. I'm very pleased to send a recording of my presentation to the Education in Crisis, Rethinking Education in Post-Pandemic South Asia Conference 2021. I am Mufida Irshad. I'm from Sri Lanka and I'm attached to one of the leading universities in the country, the University of Sri Jayawardenapura. My university is situated in the administrative capital of the country, Sri Jayawardenapura Kote. This is a picture of my university. It displays its physical beauty. Having said that, I would now like to focus on the task at hand. The topic of my presentation is A Well-Balanced Education, the Way Forward. In order to find out what a well-balanced education should be like, in post-pandemic Sri Lanka, I asked using Google Form 30 learners and 5 teachers from secondary and tertiary level educational institutes selected through snowballing sampling 2 open-ended questions. 1, what are the challenges that you face with this new way of learning? 2, should we rethink the approach to education? What should be done to respond to any uncertainties in the future? All participants responded. These are the details of the participants. The learner participants were between the ages of 18 and 21, and the teacher participants were between the ages of 30 and 40. There were both males and females. These were some of the responses given by the learners to the 2 questions. I'm not going to read out the responses since I've been only given 10 minutes for the presentation, but you can pause the video and read what the learners and teachers have to say. Here are some more responses from the learners. These are some of the responses given by the teacher respondents to the 2 questions. All right. Now that we have looked at the responses given by the respondents, what do you think the data are telling us? The message is loud and clear. It's obvious that the challenges are intense for the educational sector. The findings show that there is a digital divide, a gap in learning. It is clear from the findings that we need a different approach to teaching and learning. That online education as such does not provide a viable alternative, that both students and teachers are yearning to go back to their respective educational institutes, and that COVID-19 pandemic seemed to have had an impact on both students and educators' mental health. How do we respond to the intense challenges in the educational sector? Of course, we have to respond to the challenges in collective and adaptive ways. Firstly, we had to rethink the use of technology. What could technology be used for? That is, in addition to what we are using it for already. Authorities, while optimizing on online education systems, should implement effective interventions to cope with the psychological effects of COVID-19 on children, as it is affecting the population and remains uncertain when it will end. Schools and universities need to use technology to liberate the learner from the past conventions and connect learners in very different ways. Schools and universities should partner in network with other educational institutes. And technology could especially be harnessed to enhance student mental well-being, to advocate mental health literacy, for mental health promotion activities, to link with mental health services, and to engage a variety of health and non-health sectors, for example, education, labor, social welfare, justice, environment, etc. The challenge is to build the kind of cognitive, social, emotional qualities that are going to account for tomorrow, and that requires a very different learning environment. for education to be balanced, we need to rethink teacher training as well. How do we rethink teacher training? The teachers have a job to do to prepare students to succeed and thrive when they are back in the school environment. Thus, teachers should be trained to design innovative learning environments where they would be coaching, mentoring, and facilitating learning. Even in the best of times, that is during the pre-pandemic period, teachers did not have the training to handle socio-emotional issues. Teachers should be trained to look for the signs of mental health issues and ask some simple questions from students. Teachers should be trained to address mental health difficulties within their practice. The responses provided by the learners also indicate that they have a yearning to return to their educational institutes. Learners have to be back in their respective educational institutes and have to be learning. According to UNICEF, it is the schools and universities that offer psychosocial support, giving the learners and the teachers, of course, stability and structure to help them cope with the trauma they experience every day. According to experts, schools and universities are not only where children learn, but are also where they learn to be a good citizen, where they learn empathy, where they learn to care about others, the living skills, the social skills, the 21st century skills. The skills they learn in the interaction between the teacher and the learners, in the interaction among peers. To some learners, it is the schools and universities that provide a protective learning environment. Thus, in addition to rethinking the approach to education, steps should be taken to have the learners safely back in school and universities. Finally, I would like to conclude by saying that in rethinking the approach to education, we need to follow a balanced approach while managing the learning teaching gap, while developing strategies for implementing quality, relevant, and inclusive education. A long-term roadmap is needed to build the mental health of the learners and teachers. For mental health has been found to have a ripple effect with both short and long-term consequences for students and teachers, affecting many aspects of their lives. This, I propose, should be the way forward, finding a balance between socio-emotional well-being and education for professional development. This brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you and stay safe. These are the sources that I referred to. Thank you.